This is a live look at the St. Louis skyline, courtesy of EarthCam. Video of the arch being struck by lightning was spreading across the internet this week.
Fox 2's Michelle Medeiros talked with arch officials and shares that impressive video in a story that's all new at 6.
You may not think about it when there's nothing but blue skies, but when the storm clouds move in, do you ever wonder if the St. Louis arch gets struck?
The St. Louis Arch is 630 feet high and made of 43,000 tons of steel and concrete. In other words, it's the perfect target for lightning strikes.
Shots of the lightning were just amazing.
But as the tallest man-made monument in the Western Hemisphere, Mother Nature is known for making it her mark.
Right there on the water and kind of in an open area where there aren't any other tall buildings around it.
Pam Sanfilippo, Chief of Museum Services and Interpretation at Gateway Arch National Park, says there are lightning rods built in at the very top of the arch that run all the way down to the bedrock, and the structure itself is also anchored in the bedrock.
So people inside typically would not even feel it if lightning struck while they were either in the trams or going up to the top.
She says lightning may strike the arch even more than once during the same storm. And if you'd like to see it for yourself, there's a live stream at archpark.org.
After watching the video that was posted, it's like, oh, I think I want to do that from now on. So that's going to kind of be my go-to when a storm rolls in.
If there's ever severe weather moving through, it might sound obvious, but don't take shelter under the trees. Instead, go to the visitor center at the base of the arch and you can take shelter there. Downtown Michelle Medeiros, Fox 2 News.